Different ways to contribute to WordPress. So I want to know about WordPress, so I'm going to introduce ways to get involved in WordPress, but I don't think it has to be more in this way. It's just an example. And for example, WordPress has, if you go to the website, there's a get involved menu, and this is the page where it takes you. So when you are on the website, you know, those are main menus that are very important. We think getting involved is super important, and that's how WordPress is made. So it's called make.wordpress.org, and it's also called make WordPress. And you know, whether you're building a budding developer or designer, just by helping out, we're always looking for people to help make WordPress even better. So anybody can get involved. It's not just coders or not even just designers. For example, I'm no longer a designer or engineer. I used to do front-end development and, you know, theme, WordPress theme development, but I no longer write any code for work. But I have a place in the open source community because it's very diverse. So there are several teams. These are officially named teams, but there's some other sub-teams. So, you know, core is just writing the code of the open source WordPress software, so that's mainly how you think of as an open source contribution. But beyond that, like everything else has a team of people. For example, I think somewhat unique in WordPress community is that they have like accessibility team, community teams of people who organize meetups and WordCamps. WordCamp is a conference, and they have a group of people making video archives of those conferences and you know, talks, online talks, and testing, and even marketing. And there are people who are writing training documentation besides just user manuals. And yeah, hosting companies are involved in making the, you know, hosting environment better for people. So all these, you know, teams work together to make WordPress, not just the code. So I think that's very interesting because, you know, it's just like a company of people doing it. So it's not just a piece of code that's important, but everything involved, we call it an ecosystem. But unless those are all working together, you can't make, you know, a project work. And because WordPress really invested into making it easier for people to work, I think it has some successful time nowadays. These are example of team description. Sometimes these are not too easy for people who are seeing the first time, but it's just, you know, by reading it, you can kind of understand what each team is referring to. So I heard from Jane that they want to get more designers involved, so I'll take a design team as an example and show you some of the things they are doing. So for design team, they can pick up core tickets, which is core is all the code is not on GitHub yet. Many people want everything to be on GitHub because Git is such a, you know, widespread version control tool nowadays. But some of the old code is old code. Code is in Chark, which is a kind of old tracking system, but their design labeled that this is needs design feedback. So they are tickets for designers. And some of the components are on GitHub, and this has like a needs design feedback like labels, or needs accessibility feedback, or UI components. So all the people who are not coders, they can also get involved in issues on GitHub or Track. And we also use WordPress for our project management, which is this is a WordPress blog, and we call it P2 because because that's the name of the theme. So it's basically just a bigger blog with cyber, and you can write comments. And one unique thing is if you write a comment, it shows up real time. So if you can kind of have a conversation, even though it's not as a chat, but you know, somewhat helpful. And you can also keep track of documents, not like in, you know, putting everything on Slack, because you can document it as a reader blog. So, for example, this is a design team B2 blog. And they are always looking for designers to give feedback all the time. But as a designer, you can also, for example, if you don't think the flow to get involved is easy enough, you can suggest, hey, I want to start this project. So this is where you get started. You write a blog post proposal, and you get started with discussion. And you, they have meetings in Slack. So if you're not ready to write a long blog post first, you can kind of say, hey, I think this course needs improvement. Can we make it a project? You can suggest it. And if everybody thinks that's a good idea, you can get started. So there's nothing, you know, stopping you from getting started. So even though it's not, you know, as easy as you say, you need time and experience, but it's not very welcome community. So if you like to, you know, kind of see how things get made, you can look at the WordPress.